Us. Welcome to Praise. I'm Bobby Schuller. I am so overjoyed again just to be here with Ben Courson, my good friend and pastor. Ben, I love talking about thankfulness because, you know, it's one of those things that it's like, do you think people could just like choose to be thankful? I mean, or is it something that we have to kind of like just, like how important is thankfulness in the life of a disciple?
I'll tell you what, I believe God's commandments are God's enablements. And Paul the Apostle said, in everything, give
thanks.
Can
you stop there? What does that mean? God's commandments are God's enablement.
So when God tells you to do something, he gives you the power to do it.
Give me the power to do it. That's good.
So yeah. when Paul says in everything give thanks, he wouldn't tell you to do it if the Spirit didn't already enable you with the power to do it.
That's right.
And I mean, if you really think about it, just as we talked about in that video, 860.3 million words over our life. It takes 72 different muscles to produce speech. We're exerting all this energy into communication. And how many of those words are going to be words of gratitude and thankfulness? Here's what the Bible says again in Malachi. We're quoting Malachi. We're going to the obscure
That's
places
it, man.
Today.
Awesome.
But it says that when we speak words that are honoring God's name, that God hearkens, and the word for hearken in Hebrew is used of a dog whose ears perk up when he hears the voice of his master, hears something that interests him. That's the word used of God listening. His ears perk up. And it says he writes those words down in a book of remembrance. That's what it says in Malachi. So how beautiful is that idea that when we speak words of thankfulness, that God in this poetic imagery is writing them down in a book of remembrance. And that makes me want to speak more words of gratitude.
You know, it's interesting. I remember reading when I actually did like a formal study on happiness, because about 10 years ago, there was a lot of literature and psychology around the word happiness, not as much around like good life or this type of thing. Like, and it was interesting to find that most of the studies agreed that traumatic events in your life or great events in your life didn't permanently change your life. So what they found, like they use this, they use this example. So like if someone wins the lottery, they're gonna have like 6 months of being over the moon, you know, stoked, and they're helping people, and they're buying all the things they always wanted, and they're paying off debt, and they got all this freedom, they quit their job. But after about 6 months, they just kind of feel the same that they were before. And the opposite was true for people that went through traumatic events, say someone who lost the ability to walk, or someone who something like that, that they found that those people, on average, tend to have about 6 months of really hard downtime, but then it ended up adjusting. It kind of reminds me of, I think it was Dostoevsky said, a human being is someone who can get used to anything. You know,
And I
think that what they found though, in another study that I read, that the only thing that they've been able to prove in a lab that permanently increases a person's overall happiness were some type of discipline of thankfulness. So not just like feeling thankful, but like having some kind of a practice where I'm doing something. So like one that they've been able to replicate multiple times was every day, or every week, I'm sorry, writing down 5 random things you're thankful for. And they made the most like depressed, frustrated, sad people. And they were able to measure that over time as people did this, their overall happiness increased. And then circling back months and years later, that it stayed higher, like it stayed that way.
Wow.
So one thing that permanently changed. So like one guy was like, I'm thankful for my bed. I'm thankful for my socks. I'm thankful for my cat. Like, it would have been very hard. He felt like there wasn't a lot he could find to be happy about. And I think it's so interesting because when you read the Bible, so much is about, like even our liturgies and our prayers and the Hebrew prayers and Christian prayers, so much is about thankfulness.
It
isn't about God, like it's almost like being forced to be thankful again.
And that's not winking our eye at our suffering. You know, 50% scholars tell us of the Psalms are laments. So nearly half the Psalms are
Absolutely.
Laments.
Yeah.
But what's a massive portion of the Psalms? It's praising the Lord with loud instruments,
Absolutely.
Giving thanks for his mercy endures forever. And that's what the Bible encourages us to do. And I think, Bobby, this message is so important. And I actually want to say this to you watching at home. During the holiday season, a lot of times this is a very challenging time because there's money stress, there's financial issues that you're going through, there's family members that perhaps are no longer with you, or topographical triggers that are reminding you of heartbreak. And for a lot of people, the holidays are stressful. In fact, one study shows us that 38% of people are more stressed there's a 38% increase in stress for those going through the holidays. So this can be a stressful time, and that's why I want to encourage you to sort of disarm your stress by giving thanks. Because here's what research has also found. Not only does it increase happiness, which is very powerful. And by the way, Aristotle believed that happiness was not a feeling. It was the overall narrative arc of a person's successful life. So like looking at the entirety of your life, which I think is interesting. But also research has shown that when you're thankful, you will have greater neural sensitivity in your medial prefrontal cortex, and you'll be more predisposed to give money to a cause. So you'll be more generous. You'll actually be more intelligent. You'll be more joyful, as you pointed out. So when the Bible says in everything give thanks, this isn't a duty or a burden for us to sort of slave under. It's actually an empowering liberty that we get to walk in.
It's interesting because whenever I'm trying to think of times when I personally was in a huge rut. Sometimes hearing this stuff could feel annoying.
Yeah.
Like if somebody else, like if I heard someone on TV go, okay, be thankful. You can't, it's hard when you're in a pit. It's like you almost have to say it to yourself. You have to, if somebody else tells you to be thankful, somehow that can be annoying. But if you're in that rut and you're like, no, I'm choosing for myself to be thankful because I know that will help me. And you begin to list those things. I feel like there does have to be a commitment almost. I almost feel like when things are really good, that's when you need to be like, okay, I'm not always going to feel great. You know, maybe in a couple weeks, I'm not going to feel good, but I'm going to choose like to be thankful. I'm going to make a choice when that time comes to be thankful. So I'm equipped to get out of the rut.
It's voluntary. It's of your own volition. And here's what Paul said. He said, be anxious for nothing, but in everything, with prayer and supplication and thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. That word guard in the Greek language is used of a prison sentinel. So it will the prison sentinel of peace will stand guard over your thoughts when you keep them captive. Paul said, take your thoughts captive. The security guard of peace will make sure that peace and your thoughts stay captive in your heart and your mind. When you not only pray with your supplication and request, but with thanksgiving. And I found this in my prayer times, not to get overly uber Pharisaic here talking about my prayer times, but this has been huge for me. Is sometimes I believe God will just tell me, Ben, start thanking me for stuff. And then I start going through this list after telling him my problems and stuff I'm going through. I start to go through this list of all the things that God has done for me in prayer. And when I start giving thanks, I'm like, I feel so much peace. Hey, Hope Generators, make sure to smash that like button below. You can hit subscribe so you make sure to be notified whenever we have new videos right up there. And then you can watch our next video so you can be empowered to be a hope dealer by clicking this box right here. I love you guys, and until next time, may the hope be with you.